What is going on at the Justice Department under Attorney General Bill Barr? I mean, a number of issues coming to light this week that really deserve serious explanations. And quite frankly, it's Barr who has some explaining to do. New York Governor Cuomo lashing out at the AG today, demanding an investigation after Department of Homeland Security officials admitted in court that they lied about a decision to punish New York State. How? By denying its residents participation in the Global Entry Program. Because the Trump administration was actually mad at the state over immigration policy.
Well, look, if you're Attorney General Barr, you have to look in the mirror sooner or later, right? And you're right. There's no way he's going to go down in the book of distinguished attorneys general, in my opinion. But you had to have a modicum of self-respect somewhere when you know that you have a cabinet department, Homeland Security, that was a political ploy, that lied about it, that got caught. At one point, don't you have to do something, John, that has something to do with justice when you're the head of the Department of Justice?
I mean, it may be Barr looking in the mirror, but it's going to be the reflection on every member of the Department of Justice, including the devoted career servants. Then this week, Barr completely misled the public about the results of Operation Legend, a federal anti-crime program begun in Kansas City and set to be expanded to other cities. Take a listen.
We have named the operation, as we've said, Operation Legend, and we started rolling it out a couple of weeks ago in Kansas City. And just to give you an idea of what's possible, the FBI went in very strong into Kansas City, and within 2 weeks, we've had 200 arrests.
200 arrests? Nobody in Kansas City knew what he was talking about. And so the Justice Department had to scramble and said that Barr was including arrests dating back to December all of a sudden. So was Barr deliberately trying to mislead or lie to Americans so President Trump can brandish his campaign theme of a law and order president? I mean, when Barr speaks, what are we supposed to believe? And frankly, this is not the question that you want. You don't want to question the credibility of the person who is overseeing the Department of Justice. But at least we may get some answers from the Justice Department Inspector General on how DOJ employees are being used against protesters. I mean, the Washington Post reports that the IG will look into the role of federal law enforcement officers in the violent removal of peaceful protesters from Lafayette Park near the White House back in June. You see that there. The operation was overseen by Attorney General Barr himself, who was on hand before officers moved in on protesters. Although he denies protesters were pushed away so President Trump could do this photo op with the Bible in his hand in front of St. John's Episcopal Church. A denial, shall we say, that's it's complicated. Complicated by the fact that that's exactly what happened. The truth is so tricky sometimes, isn't it? And this week, the Attorney General was highly critical of the nationwide outrage at the killing of George Floyd while a Minneapolis police officer knelt on his neck.
We had that terrible event in Minneapolis, but then we had this extreme reaction that has demonized police and called for the defunding of police departments. And what we have seen then is a significant increase in violent crime in many cities. And this rise is a direct result of the attack on the police forces and the weakening of police forces.
I mean, we had that death, and then we had the extreme response. I mean, look, the spike in crime in our cities is absolutely alarming. Full stop. It needs to be addressed immediately. Second full stop. But you and I know that there is a certain callousness to the Attorney General calling the reaction to George Floyd's death extreme. Barr made those remarks in front of President Trump, who has shown limited empathy, shall we say, about the killing of Mr. George Floyd. I mean, last month, Barr said it's undeniable that many African Americans lack confidence in our justice system, but then, of course, said there really wasn't systemic bias or racism. And what's happened since then? The Barr Justice Department also got whacked on the knuckles this week by a federal judge who released Trump's former attorney, Michael Cohen, from prison again today to serve the rest of his sentence in home confinement. He was first released, if you recall, back in May, only to be sent back this month. The federal government was claiming that he violated the terms of his release. Now, Cohen claimed that he went back to prison in retaliation. Retaliation for writing an upcoming tell-all book about Trump. The judge saw it Cohen's way. Now, I worked in the Justice Department, and the Attorney General may be chosen by the president. He serves at the pleasure of the president, but he works for the American people, who should not be pleased to think about the Department of Justice becoming a pseudo Department of Retaliation. The Attorney General is not the president's personal lawyer. He's yours, and he's supposed to stand for justice. The Attorney General has a lot of explaining to do about his actions, and now he's running the Justice Department. And on behalf of my former colleagues who were devoted career public servants in that very department, I certainly hope he won't run morale underground.